Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 8 of our GoLang course. Since we have already covered variables and constants in the previous lessons, I thought it is a good time to go over identifiers and keywords in Go. How do they relate to variables and constants? Identifiers are the name that we give to variables and constants in our code. It will all make sense by the end of this lesson, so bear with me. In this lesson, first we will cover identifiers and what they are. We will then look at pre-declared identifiers in Go. Next, we will look at what keywords are and look at some keywords in Go. Then we will try everything out with our coding session. Identifiers are the name that you give to identify entities in your Go code, such as variable, constants, types, and functions. Throughout our lessons, when writing code, we have used variable names like myInt, myString. All these are identifiers to identify the variable. In real life, you can think of them as names that we use to identify humans. In Go, identifiers are formed by combining one or more Unicode letters and digits. You can Google for Unicode letters and digits, but generally speaking, we tend to use English letters and digits from 1 to 9. But since Unicode is supported by Go, you can use letters and digits from any other language if you want it. Go requires the first letter of an identifier to be a letter. So a variable or constant name cannot start with a digit. Please note, underscore is considered a letter. Some examples of valid identifiers are myInt, underscore mystring, alpha, beta, the two Unicode characters that we are using, and my name with an uppercase M. All these are considered valid. Now let us look at some pre-declared identifiers in Go. Go has pre-declared identifiers that are used to identify types, constants, zero values, and function. These identifier names should not be used for user-defined identifiers to prevent any confusion. As we go through more lessons in Go, you will see how they are used throughout the code. All the pre-declared identifiers are listed below. For types, these identifiers are any, bool, byte, comparable, complex, error, float, so on, int, and all the int data types, rune and string, unsigned int, and all the related int types. For constants, these are true, false, and iota. I know we haven't gone through a bunch of these, but we will cover them lesson by lesson. For zero value, the nil identifier is used. The following functions are pre-declared identifiers and should not be used to identify a variable or function in our code. Keywords in any language have a specific meaning and a function. They cannot be used for user-defined identifiers. For example, the func keyword in Go is used to create a function. The keyword package is used to create a package and should not be used as an identifier. A list of keywords in Go is as follows. Again, as we go along the Go lessons, we will go through all these keywords and use them. For now, you just need to remember that you don't use them as identifier for your variables, constants, or functions. Let's try everything out with code. First, let's go over identifiers. So as I told you, if I do var myInt int is equal to 10, and then just to remove this error with the ID is complaining because we have declared it but not used it, I can do fmt println myInt. MyInt here is an identifier for variable that I created, which is of type int. As we discussed in the lesson, we can start identifiers with letters or an underscore. So I can do this and it's still valid. What I cannot do is start the identifier with a number. You can see the error here says that it's expecting an identifier, but it found 9. So I'm just going to remove it now. If I want, I can use the digits anywhere else in the identifier except the first letter. So this too is valid. We can also start an identifier with the uppercase, like this. Go has a special meaning for uppercase and lowercase identifiers. We will go through them once we discuss packages. For now, we will just stick to lowercase starting identifiers like this. What you see here is called snake case. In snake case, the first letter is lowercase and every next word is capitalized. So if I wanted to do my int something, I would write it as my int something. I will be covering programming cases in a supplement lesson, so please keep an eye out for it. As we discussed earlier, Go has some pre-declared identifiers which should not be used for custom identifiers like my and something. So, for example, any is an pre-declared identifier. I can use it to declare our custom variable, but it should not be used to prevent any confusion. So if I run it, it works fine, but I should not do it. Another example is I can use bool for our custom identifier, and then you can see if I run the program, it will run fine, but to prevent any confusions between the bool data type and bool identifier, we shouldn't be using any pre-declared identifier. So I'm going to revert it back to my end. Another thing we discussed in our lesson is that there are keywords that have a special meaning and function in Go. The keywords in Go should not be used as identifier. So if I try to do func, which is a keyword reserved to create functions, you will see that the Go language is complaining and it's expecting an identifier but found the func keyword. If I try to run the program, you will see it will throw an error. Unexpected func expected a name or identifier. So again, I'm going to revert it back to my end. Please refer to the list of predefined keywords and identifiers so that you don't use them in your code. Another thing I wanted to mention is that in our real world, we use numbers like this, or we write numbers like this. But since comma has a special meaning in coding, this is not allowed. If I try to run the program again, you will see it's complaining about the comma between the number. Instead, what Go provides is that you can use underscore to separate the numbers by 10,000 and so on. When I try to print this number with go run main.go, you will see the underscores are omitted. So they are just syntactical sugar and they don't mean anything when used inside a number. As mentioned in our lesson, I can use Unicode letters and digits for identifiers. So if I do this, this works because these two alpha and beta are Unicode characters and they are valid identifiers, but you don't commonly use that. We stick to English letters and digits from 0 to 9. So I will revert it back again to my end. That's it for the coding session. I will see you in the next coding session.
Thanks for watching the video. If you have any questions, please feel free to comment on the video below, or you can reach out to our Discord server. I hope you enjoyed the lesson. Happy coding.